One TV special report.
As of this time, how many person?
Not yet computed by our city health office.
The turnout. But
there are barangays who already reached to 40%, 50%, and some are 27, 30. So considering the number of days remaining, so possibly we will get the 80%, Honorable Chair.
We have less than a month not to comply the 80%. What was one of the incentive?
Our good governor, Honorable Chair, initiated to give incentive for the barangays who can reach the 80%. Our provincial governor will be giving 50,000 for the barangays as reward.
For those who have reached 80%?
For those who reached 50%.
50%?
80%, sorry. 80%.
In each barangay. They have to comply the 80%, then they'll get 50,000.
That's one of the
incentive. What about those kanang giving out a rice and in kind?
Our good city mayor, Honorable Chair, also with his encouragement for the people to be vaccinated, give himself for vaccination, each one will be given 5 kilos plus six canned goods, Honorable Chair.
Okay,
incentive, Honorable
Chair. Was there any strong campaign by the barangay officials to the barangay level? Ang ato mga barangay officials, is there any strong campaign?
Yes, Honorable Chair. Barangay officials, of course, our BHW already done their house to house. So our barangay officials are also doing house to house, Honorable Chair. The intention is to how those afraid of kuan vaccination mapasabot pag maayo, Honorable Chair, kay sa pagkakaroon medyo daghan pang hesitant, mahadlok ang bot sa pagkikadlok, Honorable Chair, considering nakahimo nag first and second dose niya, booster na noon, dili nahadlok na noon sila. So mo nang kuanjod kanang man to man ang approach karon sa mga barangay officials, specific bot pasabot kinsa to nga tao, ideal siya sa unsa iyang specific pod nga concern, para lang gyud masabtan niya ang the importance of booster vaccination, Honorable Chair.
We hope that there will be a strong campaign among the barangay levels kay, and this should have also, I think, initiate some incentives, no, on top of the incentives being given to us by the Office of the City Mayor. Yes, Honorable Aswiso.
Thank you very much, Madam Chair. Yes, it is true, Madam Chair, that the Governor Henry Waminal is very, very concerned regarding the percentage of our vaccination boost, number one. In fact, the deadline is September 15, and then we need to maximize and to have an extensive campaign for the first booster, because the target is 80% and layo pa kaita. In fact, I could suggest, Madam Chair, since we have a very good community networking in our each barangay. We have our service providers. Maybe we could come up with a plan. You can propose that to the mayor nga kato mga service provider nga iyahang mga tao butang ta 20 or 30 kabuo. The first or katong mga service provider nga makapaboost atong 30 katao nga under niya will get an incentives para kining mga service provider nato other than puro presidents, other than BHW will work hard para lang gyud katong 20 to 30 katao nga under niya iyahag yung mapahurutanan o pa nagpaboost. That way we could bet the deadline nga September 15 and then mataas-taas kay kinangdan magulig push lang yun ang ato ang mga service provider ba kay grabe yung kaayo ka sincere si Governor Henry regarding sa atong 80% nga target. So by that time dapat mangita yun paagita pa more para yun makuan ang ato ang kuan community networking ug madaghan ang magpa-booster. Number one, Madam Chair.
Okay, thank you Honorable Suiso of your manifestation. Yes, we have to double time our effort, especially on the barangay level, at mga barangay officials, kay maugin ni hard campaign from even from the national level. Yes. Any other comment, remarks regarding our discussions for today? From the Committee on Health, may we hear from Honorable Lim regarding the campaign? Congratulations for your new haircut.
Thank you. Sa nagstorya pud ni sa taga City Health Office, Madam Chair, nagbuhat gyud pud sila og action nga gipurok tuporok gyud nila ang ilahang vaccination. Okay. And aside from that, taghantag mga areas ginapost sa atong Asenso Ozamis News Channel nga ang mga dili pod makabantay sa purok nga campaign nila sa vaccination, naatay public mall, naatay mga sites nga makita na to sa tong page kung asa sila pwede mo adto and naay schedule. So walay rason nga dili ta makapa second booster, and in fact even ang ilang site is ang ilang campaign for second booster mo cater gihapon sila sa Muduol labi na nga kanang wala pagay vaccination, dili na nila balibaran. So anang sa wala pa na vaksinan makater nila first booster second booster ilahang makater tanan para wala nagay rason. Unta akong ihawhag ang tanang taga Ozamis noon nga dili ta mahadlok kay taod-taod na pud ning kami tanan na labi na din sa City Council na kapabooster na. So makita na to nga effective gyud kayo ang ato ang vaccination. Daghang salamat, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Honorable Lim. Any other remarks or manifestation regarding this campaign? Wala naman siguro. Hearing none, Honorable Majority Floor Leader.
Yes, Honorable Sir. If there are no more comments, we'll proceed. And at this juncture, may we have the pleasure and privilege to hear on matters concerning the indigenous people from Honorable Bae Relinda Bation, Honorable Chair.
Honorable Bation, you are now recognized for matters concerning IP.
Thank you, Madam Presiding Officer and Majority Floor Leader. None for now, Madam Chair. None.
Okay, thank you. Yes, Honorable Majority Floor Leader.
Thank you, Honorable Chair. I now yield to my colleagues for any important announcement or any information relevant on material matters. Before I proceed to item number 15, Honorable Chair.
Yes, any other matters?
Honorable Suiso, Honorable Chair.
Thank you very much, Majority Floor Leader. Madam Chair, I just like to inform this August body that National PCL Week celebration will be this coming September 1 to 7, 2022. And then the National Board is encouraging all the city chapters and the federation to come up with a activity for the PCL Week celebration. They are suggesting if we could conduct the flag raising ceremony, or we could have ecological protection or the tree planting activity, and any other activities that the city could come up during the PCL Week celebration. But still, the Federation has yet to discuss on what would be those activities so that we could at least join or participate for the celebration, Madam Chair. September 1 to 7, 2022.
Okay, thank you, Honorable Suizo. So I hope that has been the program. Ang program of activities.
Yes, Madam Chair.
On September 1 only?
No, from September 1 to 7, there will be series of activities. Oh. And just informing this because the Federation has yet to come up with the series of activities from 1 to 7.
So I hope.
And we will be announcing that next week on what will be those activities.
Hopefully by August 30, we can
yes.
have the
series of activities. Thank you very much, Madam.
The series of activities. And on top of that, on September would be also a civil service month. So, may we request the Honorable Fuentes, Cypress? Yeah, next month is, civil service month manao. So, I hope that we can also some information regarding the celebration. Wala ba'y mga, because for 2 years, we have not celebrated the Civil Service Month, no? Maybe this time, we can have na mga minimal activity lang, no? Kamay lang activity. So,
yes,
maybe next time you can have your report also.
I will give updates regarding the Civil Service Month to be celebrated next month. But as gilabi na ko dito ni Mayor Indy, ang first katong early August, mga first week of August, nagka-istorya namin ni Mayor regarding sa celebration. But at that time, pag-istorya na mo, medyo diduso pa siya na mag-celebrate gito. But if ever ko no na mag-celebrate, especially sa ball games ko no, volleyball and basketball lang sa ang ato ang i-appeal sa ball games. And the rest, katong akong mga gipropose sa iya ha, okay man siya adto. But
good.
As of today, kay weekly kong ga-follow up niya, and then last week, naaman siya official travel adto. Until now, wala pagyug ko ka-receive o information regarding sa ato ang celebration next month. So, mauna na this time, nagpa-schedule na sad ko sa iyahang secretary if ever og dili siya busy karon ma-insert ko, but if not nag-wait lang gyud ko og unsay decision sa ato ang mayor kung maka-celebrate bata this next month sa ato ang CSC.
Okay, thank
That's
you
all, Honorable, Madam Chair.
Honorable Chair, thank you, because we have one meeting sa August 30, no? August 29 is a holiday, so but we can have August 30, Tuesday. We still have one session for the month of August,
yes,
so that can be discussed. Okay, thank you, Honorable Cypress, for your information. Is there any other information from the member of this August body? Yes, Honorable Majority.
Honorable Chair, this might be of interest to everybody.
Yeah.
On the One Family, One Professional program of the Governor of the province, Governor Henry Umnal Senior, there are 19,000 applications, more than 19,000 applications. Out of that, out of those applications, sa Samin City, we have more than 9,000. So, murag happy 50% ang applicants coming from Samin City.
Applicants
but,
for?
One Family, One Professional.
The program.
Okay. So, this is the main campaign. That 19,000 sa Osamis, the main campaign. So, it's almost 50% coming from Osamis City, on the chair. And the governor decided for press implementation, we'll target only 4,000. But, Unfortunately, sa pagbabahin-bahin na sa allocation, the may upsurge the made certain objections because gamay lang ang allocation to, ah. It's about only 20%. When the applicants, kaya pa sa amin, comprise about 50% of all applicants. So, the mayor is asking for consideration kay ubang municipalities, itaka allocation more than, even more than their applicants, sinakaaban, gamay na applicants, allocation gihatag, more than the application. So, request the consideration, itaka mga applicants sa amin is good. So, that's the latest development on that program, the Governor Honorable Chair. Per our talk with the mayor yesterday, we have a long talk with the mayor yesterday, Honorable Chair. So, if there are no more matters from my colleagues.
Okay, thank you, Honorable Majority Leader, for your information. I think this is one of the most laudable program being initiated by the Honorable Governor Nong Kaneng. One professional per family. Okay, that is very good project, laudable project. The governor, yes, the committee on education, Honorable Ko, you are now recognized by the chair.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I would just like to add more information from the one given by our majority floor leader regarding the program 1F1P. So it's a one family, one professional. We had a meeting last Friday, August 19, at the province session hall with the governor, and we were talking about the final launching of this program. Supposedly to start during the first semester of class opening on the college level. So the 1F1P program under the leadership of Governor Henry Waminal created a board of trustees mainly to attend and to plan, design the specifics and the mechanics of this program. So, Usamis, this representation is a member of the Board of Trustees. So we talk about the development of the 1F1P program and it's, as I've said, the launching of it. Since the school opening would start in the college level by from August 20, supposedly yesterday, to September, and I think extended to August 31 up to September 2. So the Board of Trustees has a separate group. They call it the technical
working group.
Consultation group with secretary created a formula to spread out the number of grantees per LGU. So, basing on that formula, the Usami City is allocated with 1,313 grantees, and regarding the information from our majority floor leader that there are some municipalities with extra allotment than their listing. Mm-mm. So it is because of that formula. So maybe at that time, the municipalities has not yet completed their listing. So as far as August 19 timetable, only 4 municipalities in the whole province submitted a complete list, and Osamis is one of the 4. We submitted a total of 9,000 applicants, but we were only, based on the formula, we will only get 1,313. Mm-hmm. So on that 9,000 plus listing nato there is Osamis, it comprises already 44% of the total 19,000 plus applicants in the whole province. So when I relayed everything, all this data to the mayor after the meeting, our good mayor came up with a sort of proposal and a little bit semi-protest on the formula. So after kano sa amanto siya nag-update. So the latest update is that from 1,313, he got an additional grantees of 450. So Osamis now will have 1,756 grantees, total of grantees. That is because of the effort of our mayor nga iyag yung i-pursue nga ang Osamis will have more number of students enjoying this scholarship. So right now there is a deadline to submit the list, no, according to the allotment of from the province. So it is a computerized system, so that they will already the system will already know whom to prioritize. So first, there are requirements already. So it will be distributed to all the LGUs in the province, and then afterwards there would be a formal turnover or formal awarding of the grantees. That is all, Madam Chair.
Okay, thank you for your very vital information, Honorable Ko, regarding that one family.
One family, one professional.
One professional, okay. That's a very laudable program of the Honorable Governor. Okay. We are happy for that. Thank you for your information.
So, gracious na. Gracious na. Kung present ang Osamis, so, kala po, almost 20% kay almost total sa naman ang Osamis.
Osamis will now have a total of 1,756 grantees from
1,700.
1,756 grantees.
From the 1,313.
From 1,313.
Oh. Okay. Daghan-daghan yun ay maka-avail, no? Thank you.
Yes, Madam Chair. And the mechanics of the prioritization will be explained to all the LGUs.
Okay. Thank you, Honorable Ko. Yes, Honorable Majority Fellow Leader.
Yes, Honorable Sir. I think there are no more other observations. Yes.
Before we wind up, may I request the Honorable Romero to take fine time on solving this problem with our affairs regarding kani mga plitihan nato sa mga kuan. Mga motor cab driver, can define time to this Honorable Romero, Committee on Public Utility.
Yes, Madam Chair. Karon ako na ko information gikan ni Jordan katong presidente sa atong motor cab drivers. Kuan gipang pull out na nila, mami. Ang mga tariff, limited tariffs nga gipang butang nila sa ilang mga motor.
Oo.
Pa-pull out na kay dayon. Mag-istorya mo ko ni Mayor karon.
Please find time to have a meeting with these concerns kay Burak.
Yes, mami.
This particular sector is in trouble.
Okay. I am planning to have a committee hearing.
Okay. Public thank you, hearing, Honorable Romero. Thank you. Any other concern from the other member of this Ongus body, from your respective committees? Doon na ba yung mga concern ninyo?
If there are none, Honorable Chair, I have no concern to maintain to the most important matter to this session. I move to adjourn, Honorable Chair.
Special report.